All right, hello everyone, and welcome back to Daily Update, my 1000 day challenge. This is day 186, so let's get things started. All right, so first and foremost, you notice the equity is up a little bit, and that's actually due to mainly the experimental trade setup. There's a winning trade in terms of Bitcoin. It took a very short in terms of short-term trade in terms of long setup, and it actually hit nicely before actually fall back right now in the 34.8K region. And as for the main trading setup, there was some sort of update in terms of the trade because I remember I closed the trade in terms of 50-50. So there was a little bit more profit that's updated over here and reflected. Otherwise, that's about it. And yeah, in terms of the main market structure update in the traditional market itself, you do see that the main change will actually be Nasdaq transiting from a bearish to a neutral market structure. And potentially we do see some decent bounce that you can be observed in terms of price action on the daily chart. So yeah, basically a nice green candlestick. That being said, after hitting the first 50 simple moving average as support, although potentially could still be rejected by the 20 exponential moving average and then fall below to here as the secondary support. So that is something that I would like to see in order for me to add more. Otherwise, it could still be a continuation towards the further upside momentum itself. And thus for Nasdaq, actually a much stronger bounce. It didn't even hit the 50 simple moving average. So that's something to bear in mind. But yeah. And for ASHR, we do see some sort of small little bounce. So potentially we could continue towards the upside, in which case I'll continue to add if it goes above this $43 region. That's where I see that potentially the retracement will have been completed. Otherwise, potentially we could have one more small little bounce towards the downside, which is where I would love to enter. But yeah, if I do miss it, then I'll catch it around the $43 range mark. KWEB similarly has very decent bounce. So yeah, things is not even near the 20 exponential average just yet on the daily chart. And finally, for Bitcoin itself, it's on the daily chart, it still looks quite okay. We're being supported at the 50 simple moving average. Even though we've been rejected off of here, we still seem to be climbing towards upside, which is a good momentum. So even though it was cleanly rejected off, price didn't really stay much below it. In fact, it didn't even close below the low of this candle, which is actually a 31990. In fact, for the 1, 2, 3 consecutive day, and we remain in a very nice range bound region with actually relatively low volume. So I'll say that the sellers are a little bit indecisive in terms of stepping up. So I do lean the potential we could go towards the upside, especially when we've sort of break above this downslope trend line in that sense. Bearing in mind that I never really like to trade downslope trend line because especially downslope, upslope trend line tend to be a little bit subjective in terms of where you draw it, and the region tends to be a little bit wide if you want to be a little bit more conservative as well. All right, in terms of price action wise in the 4-hour chart, I still don't see a very nice action. So over here, potentially we could have a bullish market structure, even though I've updated it. But the reason why I'm not entering based on price action, for systematic trading, I'm okay with entering because that's systematic wise. For price action, due to subjectivity, I would not be entering this trade. As you can see over here, in terms of statement wise, I'll still wait for clearer price action or pattern. And reason being is very simple. Price is very hovering near this 200 simple moving average on the 4-hour chart, which means it's very choppy. And if you switch towards the line chart, you'll see it's very, very choppy. So could literally swing up and down and just hit your stop losses. So when you're dealing with price action trading, you generally want that particular time frame that you're trading to be less choppy in that perspective. So for example, this type of trading action, yes. This type of consolidation and breakdown also, yes. So you see lower highs, then yeah, lower high, and then we're going to break. So you can short over here with a stop loss over there, right above, and then you can write it over here, see a strong support, and then you could close your trade itself. So that is purely based on price action wise. On the other hand, over here, it's just too choppy for me. In fact, what I would suggest is look into other pairs. Ethereum, in fact, is something that I'm looking to enter. I've actually entered long because it's a much nicer price action. So yeah, I'll definitely suggest looking into Ethereum or even other crypto pairs if you're looking to trade in terms of price action for now. And I'll definitely be staying out of Bitcoin in terms of price action for now. So otherwise, that's more or less the update I have for you guys today. And I'll see you guys tomorrow. Take care. Bye-bye.